Who were our primordial ancestors? You may have heard that humans are most closely related to the apes, and this is true. Chimpanzees are genetically closest to humans. In fact, they share about 98.5% of our DNA. However, although humans and chimps have many identical genes, we did not descend from apes. It's rather that apes and humans have a common ancestor that lived in Africa roughly 8 million years ago. No one has yet uncovered the fossils of this common ancestor, so for now it is the missing link. Let's go way back in history and look at some of the members of our long lineage. Living around 6 million years ago in Africa, Aurorin is one of the earliest bipedal hominins. Individuals of this species were approximately the size of a chimpanzee. Their long, curved fingers and toes indicate that they spent a lot of time up trees. But the shape of their thigh bones confirms that this species was likely bipedal. Then Australopithecus came along. Its body shape was more ape-like than human-like. It had long forelimbs and the first toe adapted for climbing trees. Its tooth enamel analysis suggests it ate fruit. It is highly likely that Australopithecus was able to walk upright, but probably not long distances. Australopithecus became the next link in the evolution of man. It was a genus with different hominin subspecies. They were terrestrial ape-like animals. For example, like apes, they had small brains and small bodies. Long forelimbs with curved fingers and toes indicate that Australopiths were still good tree climbers. It is quite possible that they slept up trees, so that predators below wouldn't get them. Australopithecus fossils show that they were bipeds, as their feet were already adapted for bipedalism, although it was too early to travel long distances on foot. The teeth of some species resembled those of humans. It appears that Australopithecus were mostly omnivores. At that time, Africa's forests started to give way to open savannas, so Australopithecus started to switch to grasses and sedges. The diet of Australopithecus sediba apparently consisted of wood and bark. Australopithecus' diet probably included some meat. Most of it came not from hunting, but from scavenging dead animals and raiding reptile nests, with the captured meat eaten raw. Several distinct hominins roamed eastern Africa more than 3 million years ago. Very little is known about Kenyanthropus. It was significantly different from other hominid species, mainly on account of its flat face and small molars. Recent discoveries suggest that Kenyanthropus was perhaps the first species to use stone tools more than 3 million years ago for bashing open nuts or dead logs. But these earliest tools were not essential for their survival, so the Lamequian culture disappeared. Nearly a million years later, Australopithecus garhi emerged. It may be the oldest hominin species to make chipped stone tools. They were probably the species which developed the Ordovician culture. The tools were used mainly as hammers for cracking nuts or breaking bones open to get to the desired marrow within. Around 2 million years ago, climate change greatly affected the populations of Australopithecus, leading eventually to their extinction. But these environmental conditions were more favorable for Paranthropus, also known as the robust Australopithecus. It had a comparatively small body, but its strongly built jaws and large cheek teeth were well suited for consuming hard plant foods. Its other features include a well-developed sagittal crest, which served as an attachment surface for strong chewing muscles. Paranthropus mostly fed on grasses and sedges. Most scientists believe that these species did not make stone tools, but abrasions on stick-shaped animal bones found alongside their fossils suggest that the species may have used these bones as tools for digging up edible roots or for excavating termite mounds. The first known species of the genus Homo appeared in East Africa about 2 million years ago. The oldest representatives, the Handyman and the Rudolph Man, were not much different from Australopithecus. Both had large, broad, ape-like faces. The shape of their feet had clearly evolved into that of today's humans, with the big toe parallel to the other toes. The species Homo habilis was long thought to be our earliest ancestor who made primitive stone tools. However, as we saw earlier, at least one group of ancient hominins had started napping stones specifically to make tools long before previously thought. This discovery disproves the long-standing assumption that Homo habilis was the first toolmaker. Therefore, many scientists believe that this species should be reclassified as a subspecies of the genus Australopithecus. The handyman and the Rudolph man gathered wild-growing fruits, dug up roots from the ground, hunted, and used stone tools to prepare animal carcasses to be used as food. A new stage of evolution turned a skilled man into a working man. The anatomy of this species represents an evolutionary leap over other previous species. Their gait and body proportions were human-like, with relatively elongated legs and shorter arms with respect to the torso. In terms of species survival, Homo ergaster is a huge success story. Diversified food sources marked the transition from scavenger to hunter. They were the earliest humans to master the control of fire, which they may have used for cooking purposes. The Acheulean stone tool technology was developed by Homo ergaster. They were the first human species to make hand axes, picks, knives, and cleavers. These were sophisticated stone tools which were probably used to handle meat, wood, or plants. It is believed that Homo ergaster began to spread across the African continent about 2 million years ago, with some individuals later leaving it for good. This small population, which emigrated from Africa, was called Homo erectus. The first wave reached the Caucasus, where the Demonesi hominin emerged. Then the species spread to Eastern Asia, with Peking man stemming from them. After that, they settled in Southeast Asia, across islands of Indonesia. Approximately 1.5 million years ago, a small group of Homo erectus migrated from Africa to Europe and gave rise to pioneer man. It is believed that the population left behind in Africa likely gave rise to Heidelberg man. Homo naledi may have emerged at around the same time. Around 400,000 years ago, a small group of Heidelberg people migrated out of Africa and then split. One part moved west into Europe, where the cold conditions led them to evolve peculiar facial features and a stockier build. Because of the cold, it was the first species to build simple shelters and hunt large animals. Their toolkits were more sophisticated and belonged to the later Acheulean industry. The second group of Heidelberg people moved east into Asia and became a separate species dubbed the Denisovans, and a species of ancient humans in the Philippines stemmed from them. In Europe, the Heidelberg man gave rise to the Neanderthals. The central part of their face protruded forward and was dominated by a very big, wide nose. They had a more robust build. These defining features were evolutionary adaptations to cold environments. At some point, Neanderthals learned how to use thick, furry animal hides and find shelter in caves to keep warm and dry. It was difficult to find plants during the Ice Age, so they primarily fed on hoofed mammals. Neanderthals used more advanced and specialized flint tools of the Mousterian industry. Around 350,000 years ago, the ancestors of the Heidelberg man remaining in Africa likely gave rise to the early Homo sapiens. Approximately 200,000 years ago, a small population of Homo sapiens set out from Africa to Eurasia and reached the current Middle East and China. The second wave of Homo sapiens spread across Europe and Asia, reaching the Australian continent. About 10,000 years ago, the Ice Age ended, and the Earth's climate became warmer and more stable. As a result, human population rapidly increased and spread throughout most of the rest of the world. We hope you enjoyed our story about the family tree of humanity, whose complex and dense branches go back millions of years. Meanwhile, humans are still evolving. It seems that over the past 100 years, more and more humans have been born with a third arm artery, a new bone, and without wisdom teeth. Thank you for watching. See you next time.